The operation was a success, but your friend's immune system is not in a condition to visit anytime soon. Please go home and let her heal in peace. We will contact you when she is better.
Hello? Are you awake? I heard when you arrived. Is it dark in your cell too? Not much of a talker, eh? It's okay. I'm just glad to have someone to talk to again. It's been lonely since Oh, I can hear her. She doesn't like when we're noisy.
The doctor wants to see you. Down to the left. Be quick. Too slow. Down to the left. Be quick.
Oh my! What happened to your arms? You don't know. Oh, silly me. Here I sit with a big mask on my face and can't remember losing my own legs. And still, I ask you my rude question. Pardon me, dear. I'm becoming an impolite old lady ever since I arrived here. It's this place. They are so rude. They treat you like an animal, so I started acting like one to get what I want. I got a mask like theirs. Why shouldn't I need one when they do? But I didn't get a key card, so I can't move around as freely as I... I'm sorry, dear, I'm such a blabbermouth. Now, I've talked myself awfully thirsty, and I just got these pills from the doctor. Would you be a dear and get me some water? I think the other one is working fine, dear.
We are on a break.
Dance good. Would you like them to dance with me? What are you looking at? I just forgot my key card.
Oh, thank you, dear. I'll just sit here for a while before I go back to my crowded sleeping quarters.
Next.
I think it's you, dear. I hope to see you again soon. Then I'll tell you what happened to my legs.
Take a seat. You know, you are a very lucky girl. Had our caretaker not driven by the moment you fell off those rocks and immediately brought you to a competent doctor like myself, you would not sit here today. The drug I use in your treatment often affects the vocal cords, so don't waste your breath. Good boy. Do you know where you are? You are at the privately run emergency room, Saint Icarus. You see, since the financial crisis took its toll on the health system, the government savings have hit especially hard in the low population areas. Had it not been for our generous and anonymous benefactor, there would not have been an ER on this island today. Luckily, we're here, so we can help many unlucky tourists, such as yourself. I had to take them. I will not lie to you. There is still a long way to go before you can go home. You've been out for days. We have been in contact with your family. When you are healed, they will fly in to see you. You will feel a little sting. In the meantime, do as we say, and don't get disturbed by some of our more mentally confused cases. You need to rest for the injection to have the best possible effect. You can go now.
Doctor said. I'm sorry.
the trash can. This is not a shopping mall. Get your royal ass back to your cell.
Are you spying on me again? Don't you look at me like that, you animalist freak. Go back to your cell and get some rest. Or maybe you will soon miss a leg too.
I can hear you're back. You still can't talk, huh? It's still dark in here. Or as we say where I'm from, der Bellmarkt. The doctor told me it's normal for some to lose their sight for a while under the treatment. I just didn't think I would be one of those. But I'm starting to eat more, and that must be a good sign, don't you think? Well, it was nice to talk to you. Good night, neighbor.
Too slow.
Wake up, Sleeping Beauty. Go get something to eat before you see the doctor. And don't you dare puke.
I have an appointment that day.
Oh, okay. Maybe another time then. Hey, stupid girl who forgot her aunt. Get the move on.
Hello, dear. Ah, you're a little late for breakfast, but I saved you something to eat. I promised you the story of how I lost my legs. Well, the doctor told me that I slipped on some rocks. Apparently, I landed utterly wrong. Lucky for me, the caretaker just happened to drive by when it happened, so that the good doctor could help me. Well, that's the story he told me. I know it's not very interesting. I hoped for a story with me bravely fighting off some big shark attack, You know what? I will soon move to your neighborhood. The doctor also said that I will soon be on the same magical drug as you, and that it will have me ready to leave in no time. So, we just have to hang on a bit more, you and I. He wants me off the pills when I start on the new drug, but I've already decided to stop taking them. They only seem to make me tired, and I'm tired of being tired. Oh, dear. Now my mouth has run away with me again, and you probably need to be somewhere else.
Who's daddy's bit? Yes, have you felt any dizziness since yesterday? Okay, it's normal. Don't strain yourself and remember to eat frequently. Don't move. I told you not to move. All this excitement just because our caretaker handles our rat problem in an unusual way. You should be clear-headed now, because my personally designed energy shot is the best in the business. So, would you please stop running around when there is no reason for it? I am wasting precious time on you.
Who's a good boy?
Another one.
I know, but I've cleaned for you. No problem.
Thanks.
You can thank me with a little dance this weekend.
Do you need me?
No. He's not going down today. You just relax.
Thank you.
Here she is, Mario.
Bye-bye.
I am so glad to see your friendly face. I just saw a strange one-legged man jump past me. What is going on? Something has changed tonight. The walls are talking, and no one is listening except me. I heard the doctor. He wanted someone to check on patient Typhon. I don't know what that means. The emergency exit is locked. There must be some kind of main computer that controls all the exits. But why would someone ever lock the emergency exits? I can feel it in my old bones. There is something rotten here. If we are...
Bye-bye.
I am so glad to see your friendly face. I just saw a strange one-legged man jump past me. What is going on? Something has changed tonight. The walls are talking, and no one is listening except me. I heard the doctor. He wanted someone to check on patient Typhon. I don't know what that means. The emergency exit is locked. There must be some kind of main computer that controls all the exits. But why would someone ever lock the emergency exits? I can feel it in my old bones. There is something rotten here. If we are going to leave this ER, then I think we must find our own way out. My dear, you got the legs, so I think it is up to you.
Thank you.
I'm not sure. It looks like something attacked one of the power generators and opened all the cell doors.
The cell doors? Are they all out?
Some, but don't worry. I took care of most and I blocked doors, so no one will get away.
Doctor, there's something wrong. And I mean, really wrong with patient Typhon.
No!
What is wrong?
He's moving. We need to get help.
Okay.
No!
No.
We must fix it.
How?
I don't know. We can, well, you know.
Catch the lost ones and get the power back on.
Yes, do that.
What about me?
You find somewhere safe.
Is it safe downstairs?
As safe as usual.
Good. Thank you. Thank you. Did you catch them?
I got the big one.
Good.
I trapped him in room 237 by using all the rats of bait.
How big is he?
Too big.
In such a short time, he is really valuable data.
He is problem.
What about the other one?
I did not see her. But I will find her when I transfer the power from generator B to A. You should get the lights back on. But don't turn on your computer just yet. Just to be safe, okay?
Yeah, I'm not an idiot.
Wake up, Dougie. There's no fun if you're not fighting for your life.
Yo, I got the power back on.
Finally.
I will go look for the armor. Ano? See.
What?
They can hear us. Down there.
I am Dr. Victor West. In the event that I cannot contain the experiment, I would like to make sure that the truth does not disappear. Therefore, I am making this recording on the 24th of September, 2011, in my secret lab where the others do not dare come. They have not yet learned that the creatures are totally harmless as long as one carries their scent. 2.5 years ago, I was contacted by an anonymous benefactor. She wished I continue an unorthodox study that had shown promising signs of healing people at a level never seen before. Lost limbs growing out stronger than ever. As a researcher and a man of science, it is my duty to provide cures that can save thousands of lives, so I could not say no. Since coming here, I have literally been a prisoner. I refused to do any experiments on humans, and I took every precaution I could. But our benefactor was impatient. I would guess that either she or someone close to her was deeply dependent on my results, so they forced me to start making experiments on humans. I was promised we would only use subjects whom society would not help. Subjects in miserable situations that I maybe could save through the experiment. I later learned the truth. I observed in horror as one victim after another was brought here to Saint Icaros. I saw no other way to stop these vicious attacks than by pursuing and succeeding with my experiments. I kept remembering that this could lead to the greatest medical discovery since the vaccination. Think of the thousands of people in pain who would benefit from my work. But I'm afraid that despite my good intentions, I have failed. I hope I can contain the failed results we have here on the island so they do not spread. But in the event that I fail to do this, let these words cast some light on the truth. Oh, the code for the main computer is CQB space 241. It should give you control over this place.
You? How did you get past the... Never mind. Stay here, and I will get some help.
To the small elevator is not safe. Use the back way to get to the big elevator. Don't look back, cause shit is happening. Doctor, are you alright? It's you. What have you done to the doctor? I hope you die down there.
Yeah.
Oh, my! What happened? You got aunt? Never mind now. You got the code for the main computer. Then hurry! Unlock the exit!
Big beast!
If only I hit you harder with the ambulance that day. Ah, the monster is awake. So, you got yourself some arms. Are you proud of what you have done? You helped that big thing kill everyone. I have fixed your fire, and now I have to kill that Godzilla. If the doctor had not said no, you would not have woken up again. But he will see you for what you really are. Monster.
what you really are, monster.
Doctor has a cure. upstairs, in his office. Please! Don't kill me!
I see you. There is no place to run and no one to save you now. This time, you die!
Stop! Can you still understand what I'm saying? Please, move a little back to show that you can understand me. Please, let me help you. I'm just going to give you a little injection with the cure.
What is it? It's a monster. Shoot it.
I see you. There is no place to run and no one to save you now. This time, you die!
Please, stop! Can you still understand what I'm saying? Please, move a little back to show that you can understand me. Please, let me help you. I'm just going to give you a little injection with the cure. You stupid, pathetic little girl. Did you really think that I would let you destroy my life's work?